The world of badminton has arrived in New Zealand, in the largest of the country city in Auckland. Beautiful part of the world with some gorgeous views there of the harbour and the Sky Tower. And of course, all the attention right now, though, is on the North Shore Events Centre, which is just north of the bridge over from downtown Auckland, with the highest ranked badminton ever to be held in this country, the Skycity New Zealand Badminton Open. And this is your lineup for the semi-finals on our show court, starting off with the brother-sister combo, Markis Kido, the former Olympic champion, up against the scratch pairing of Wu and Xia. He Bing Zhao, so good in China just a couple of weeks ago, up against another teenager. That's going to be a great battle, one for the future, Aya Ahori. Then Bunsok Pasana, of course, the veteran, up against Chao Bin. And then Xiao in action again, this time in the company of Zhong in the women's double. They take on the Indonesian pair of Dao and Marissa. And then men's doubles to conclude our action here on this Saturday in Auckland. Well, they're the expensive seats. We have a wonderful view of both courts. And it's great to see so many youngsters here keeping an eye on what is bound to be a great day's badminton. We've got a nice mix of young guns and old timers, the next crop of Chinese and Japanese youngsters up against some stalwarts. That's the New Zealand Open Trophy. And it's filling up nicely inside the North Shore Events Centre. Been hosting badminton, international badminton that is, in this country since the New Zealand International back in 1990. This, though, the third staging of the Skycity New Zealand Open. It is just about lunchtime. But they're looking forward to things. It should be a great day's action. I'm Richard Kaufman, alongside New Zealand's doubles specialist, Oliver Layden-Davis, and we're looking forward to what should be a cracking lineup of semi-final action. Really is, isn't it? Some of the future stars up against some people, maybe ladies, their best days are behind them, but girls, still capable of winning badminton matches.
Absolutely. Good afternoon, Richard, and good afternoon to everybody. It's great to be back at the Skycity Open for 2015. We have, like you say, there's a lot of young versus old in the lineup this afternoon, and we see that in the first match in the mixed doubles with Markis Kido and Zebadiah, Bernadeth from Indonesia, with their experience against a young Chinese combination of Yu Xiaoyu and Huan Xia. So it'll be an interesting test first up.
Yeah, and it's a great place to start, particularly with you alongside me, because we're looking there, the guys in the yellow, Markis and Pia, brother-sister combination. Now you obviously have had that in the mixed doubles yourself, your sister obviously plays badminton as well. How is that? Because of course it's great, you know each other so well, but then again, you know each other maybe too well sometimes.
Yeah, absolutely. To be honest, it's the best part of it is when it goes really, really well. You can feed off each other. You know how things work, and it's great to share someone that you're that close with and share those experiences on a badminton court. So the good gets really good.
I suppose Markis being the older person, the guy that's got the Olympic medals in the bag as well, very much then the senior partner, the one that will certainly tactically work things.
Absolutely, yeah. He's very skillful, has been for a number of years, and he certainly knows his way around a badminton court. So,
what's it going to be like for him? He's got to play two matches today. Obviously, fitness-wise, I mean, you look at him. I mean, I know he's very agile. I know he's a great player, but you look at him, and you know, Shah's also playing two matches today, but she looks maybe the fitter of the two. If I'm being blunt about it.
Oh, absolutely. Certainly Markis will be, he's a very skillful guy and he's a very intelligent badminton player at the same time. So look for him to dominate the tactical side of the game and really stamp his mark that way.
So it's China up against Indonesia. There's the sister, Pia Zebadiah Bernadeth. She was in a marathon match last night. I mean, it was only, 13 hours ago she came off court having given away four match points.
Yeah, she'll be thrilled to come away on the winning side of that one. The shuttles have been a little bit slow all week. It's been a bit easier to defend in this hall, so look for plenty of long rallies and plenty of quality defense from both sides.
They've been a pair since 2013. Pierre and her brother Markis. As for the pair on the other side of the court, as we look at Markis Kido, who has obviously been there and done it as far as badminton is concerned. Wide title in 2010 Olympic. In 2008, that was alongside, of course, Hendra Sediarwan. As you can see, they're the third seeds in this event, ranked 23. This year, well, first round loss in the Malaysian Masters, All England Swiss Open, last 16 of the Malaysian Open and Singapore Open. So this is certainly their best event. This pair, though, they are a scratch pair. So in terms of their experience together, not too much to really report. Xia, though, very experienced player, isn't she? Certainly at the women's doubles level, Oliver. As you can see, in terms of together with Wu, not much to talk about, but you know, she's been there and she's won Super Series events in the women's doubles before.
Certainly be good for you to play with a girl like that who has that much experience and that much skill. When she can take control of the net, it'll make him a lot better and his life a lot easier in the back half of the court.
Yeah, he as far as international badminton experience is concerned, this is fairly a new thing, isn't it? It's only his fifth tournament in the international stage, only the third of this year. So she, unlike the other side of the event, she's going to be the senior person here. She's the one that's going to have to try and dictate things.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, certainly on, it's an interesting matchup with Markis having the more experience on the Indonesian side. But look for the Chinese girl to try and dominate with the over early on. She'll look to move forward and take the net and really stamp her mark there.
Kido and Pierre Zebadiah Bernadeth, Indonesia. Pierre Zebadiah Bernadeth to serve to Xia Huan. Love all, play.
So Cynthia Tamarapat gets play underway for the Skycity New Zealand Badminton Open semi-finals.
Service over, one love.
And it's an interesting contrast, isn't it? Olympic champion Markis Kido alongside his sister Pia Zebedia Bernadeth up against this scratch Chinese pairing. Who off to a decent start. Xia Huan and Wu Xiaoyu off to a two-love start.
Really look to see a lot of that from the back line from Markis Kido this afternoon. You just bring the shuttle down, not 100% full smash, but just wait for the opportunity to come in and move forward.
They're the Chinese pair. A bit like they're on the back foot, but how quickly did they get on the front foot?
Yeah, absolutely. It's sort of a theme we've been seeing all week. Richard is quite comfortable to defend in here and move the shuttle around. So Kido's going to be really careful with its attack. Make sure he can't get countered to the other side, as happened just before.
How important a role does the lady play in this mixed doubles in terms of trying to dominate that net?
It's huge, Richard, to be honest. If the Chinese lady, say, is dominating the net, it's going to make life very difficult for Pierre and also for Markis, because he's always trying to play the shuttle up
again,
and that makes it hard for him to win any points from that situation.
So service fault call there. got to be below the ribs, yeah?
Has to be below the bottom rib, the contact point, yes, exactly.
Questioning it from Pierre, but point goes the Chinese way. Well, he might be inexperienced at this level, but showing no lack of confidence, is he?
No, he's certainly capable of dropping the hammer from the back line, so he can give it a good clip. And look to see that more this afternoon. Good signs early for the Chinese pair. They certainly seem to have more danger in their attack than the Indonesians so far.
An early sign of some frustration there from Markis Kido?
A little bit. It's just not quite going how we would like it to so far, but I think that's exactly how we're going to see him play throughout the match. You just keep it down, keep it short, wait for the Chinese to try and turn it over and then come in and take his opportunities.
Service over.
Great net coverage there from Pierre. The more she can do that, the more Markis' life is going to be easier behind her as well.
I mean, both these pairings, obviously mixed doubles, obviously a scratch pairing for the Chinese, but for the Indonesian pairing, well, they're ranked 23 in the world, but they're the sixth best Indonesian ranked mixed doubles pair. They got some stiff competition. I mean, they're nowhere near making the Sudirman Cup squad in a couple of weeks' time.
Yeah, it's crazy how much depth Indonesia has in the mixed doubles at the moment.
Yeah, Liliana. That's it to Toei Ahmed, of course, the top ranked pair.
Service over 4-9.
That's where he wants it.
5-9.
Yep, exactly. He's just looking for that half chance in the midcourt so he can put more pressure on and sustain and keep moving forward. It's hard with the slower shuttle once you get that pressure on to be able to lift out and start again. So look for Markis to continue to do that.
Whose turn to dominate that rally?
Service over.
They got off to a flying start in this New Zealand Open, did this Chinese pair, knocking out the number two seeds, Danny Krishnanta and Vanessa Nair in round one. Had a three-gamer in yesterday's quarter-final. That's just long, but I suppose when you're a scratch pairing, you don't mind too much time out on court, and they've made a very good pet start, haven't they, here? Hu Xiaoyu and Xia Huan, 11-5, their interval lead.
Yeah, certainly a comfortable lead going into the interval of the first set. Let's look for something the Indonesians not to change too much after this break. They've been doing some good things, but they seem to be making more mistakes than the Chinese at the moment. They are going to have to work hard. The Chinese pair are definitely more dangerous when the shuttle goes up. 1-4.
Well, too early to start making any real significance of that first part of that opening game. But what you can say is it's been a confident start, hasn't it, from the Chinese pair, obviously. Xia with a lot of experience, not so for Wu, but he settled well.
Yeah, they've certainly started at a higher pace of the two pairs and have really been able to benefit from that in these first 11 points. I don't think Markis Kido and Pierre are going to give in that easily, though.
Oh, well, if it was long, that was a bad miss, wasn't it, from Markis Kido? Look for the umpire to overrule it, but he did. But she didn't, did she? Think, or my instinct was it was long.
It was very, very close. Well, probably not in the best position to see it from up here, but.
Spoken like a true pro there, you know. It's a tough job, isn't it, for the line judges, but it was a tight call, but I think he's more disappointed with himself than the line judges.
Yeah, it just seems to be the way things are going for him at the moment. He's creating opportunities and then just at the last shot needs to put it either in the net or just out the sideline. But there we go, more straight away, positive signs for the Indonesian pair.
It's like the old adage for a football centre forward, at least you're in the position to miss if you do miss, and that's an encouraging sign, isn't it, for the Indonesian pair, that they're getting these chances now.
Exactly, yeah, I think it's only a few mistakes that the reason they're a few points behind them. Again, Kido's just showing his skills and experience.
12.
Points in a row.
10-12.
It's cut the deficit nicely, hasn't it, for Pia and Markis.
First point since the interval that the Chinese have been able to have the attack and bring the shuttle down straight away. It pays dividends for them. It's going to be certainly key for the Indonesians to win this match that they can keep it down and be the ones attacking more than the Chinese pair. Great return that.
Service over. 11-13.
Yeah, Fu was hoping that was going wide. He was very miscalculated in what he was seeing there.
Break as the Pia seems to fix it here. Tactical or required, we'll never know. But no, definitely not.
Hey, sorted. Looks like we're ready to get back underway. Excellent rally that from Kido. And
service over, 12-14.
His sister there, they really have the measure. And since the interval, there's been a slight change in the way this game is going.
Yeah, the Indonesians have turned this round nicely since the break. Now they're the ones in the offense 95% of the time, and it's proven to be the reason why they're getting back in the game.
11. Service over, 15.
A little bit 13. Ambitious there from Markis Kido. Looking for Yu to move towards the back of the court to where he needs to cover and leave the net open, but he was still there.
How good is it to see someone like Kido who's achieved so much, though still this hungry, you know, and playing not events that are necessarily beneath him, but, you know, he's played at the highest level, won Olympic gold. Yet here he is, desperate to be in Rio in 2016, you know, playing here, men's doubles. He's back with his old coach again.
Yeah, absolutely. It's been, I mean, obviously he won the gold in the men's doubles, so maybe the mixed doubles is another challenge for him. That's maybe what's keeping him hungry and trying to look for some more medals.
Yeah, well, he's in the men's doubles later, and obviously the new partner there, he's 14, had a few since he split 16. Up with Indra Sediar. And his old coach is actually his new partner's dad. So there's a nice little kind of going back to your glory days for him there. And maybe it's just brought back a little bit more appetite. He's desperate to make it through to Rio. Thinks he can, but won't be happy with that.
Service over.
Yeah, absolutely.
17,
I mean,
14.
In a way, it must be hard for him as well to see his former partner go to world number one with Muhammad Ahsan and do so well as he has. And maybe he's desperate to catch up and get back to where he was.
Yeah, of course, not part of the national setup. An independent shuttler is Markis Kido now, has been for a few years.
18, 14.
Untimely miss from Pia there. So 4-point buffer for the Chinese towards the end of the first set.
Fault receiver. 19,
fault receiver. Markis Kido just moving too early there. Remember, you cannot lift your foot before the shuttle leaves the racket. It's interesting, Richard, to see a forehand serve in a mixed doubles.
It didn't come off either, so why isn't that a popular
15,
thing to do?
19.
Basically, it's to do with the contact point. If you serve forehand, it's a lot harder to control the shuttle because you're further away from the net. And if you're serving backhand, you can stretch out further, and like Pia there can get her contact point with the shuttle to be a lot closer to the net.
That's just why
a serve that goes down
service
faster.
Over. Sorry, 20 game points.
It's come brought up game points as well. And a chance for the Chinese pair here to take the first game of these semi-finals. And there you go, Kido nets. And
first
Wu
game
Xiaoyu
won and by Yu Xiaoyu and Xia Huan. 21-15.
As you heard from our umpire, they're 21 points to 15. It looked like in the second part of that game that maybe the Indonesians were going to turn it around. But in the end, Wu and Xia stayed firm, stayed steady, and saw it through pretty comfortably.
Yeah, it did turn out comfortable for the Chinese. The first game, they took a lead early on and never relinquished it. So, but I think Markis Kido, like you say, has been around for a long time. He knows his way. And look for his experience to come through in this second set. There were some good signs from them in the first set. Just a few mistakes that let them down at key times. So look for them to turn that around in set number two.
Yeah, it's amazing. There's a scratch pairing that they're able to march on like this, but we see it so often, don't we? And sometimes it can be familiarity breeds contempt, and sometimes a scratch pairing like this, it can be exciting, can't it?
Certainly can, especially with conditions like today.
There's no count, but
we've got a slightly slower haul here.
You hear me?
So it's a bit easier to defend, and that can expose some any rotational issues that they might have. Extended interval here, not quite
court
sure
one,
what's happening.
20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds. I'll just go without.
Possible technical issues for the umpires.
Wait.
Yeah, I think she's lost
second
a little
game
bit of her communications.
Level. Play.
Cynthia Tam, happy to go on without it. Well, Markis Kido is adamant that was long. The line judges said it was good. 15. Come on, Oliver. 17. Tell us.
I'm going to say good from the brief glimpse that I did get.
So, a little bit of controversy on the opening point, but it's case now of Markis Kido and Pia Zebadiah Bernadeth of giving it everything, trying to get this back to one game or take it to a third set.
It's great defense from both sides in that rally. There was clear-cut chances to put some pressure on, and both sides are able to turn it over straight away.
Perfectly placed by Yu. That really was a classy shot.
Yeah, Huan really showing her class there in the defense as well. Half court smash from Markis and just able to turn it away and set up her partner.
Oh, that's given wide. Everything's going against Markis. I tell you what, I thought that hit the line, but I've not got as good a view as the line judge.
No. But yeah, there's certainly been some close calls, and it took at least one from to go Markis's way on these 50-50 ones.
And when those calls go against you like that, you know, you're in a match like this. Listen, he's put it behind him. He's played a beautiful shot there down the line. How hard is it to put it behind you, though?
It depends on the timing. If it gets towards 18-all, 19-all, it's tough. You've got to be ready again straight away, especially when you get two or three to go against you. It can be a bit downing, but the class player that Markis is, I don't think he'll affect him too much.
Yeah, he's seen it before.
Certainly has.
Of course, in Super Series events now, you've got a chance to challenge, haven't you? Used the video evidence, but not at this level, Grand Prix gold level.
No, but I mean, I think it's great that has come in the Super Series. And hopefully in the next couple of years, that can filter down through to the Grand Prix events as well, and it's all better for the sport.
Especially if they're being televised like this is now, these Grand Prix gold events are, then why not use the technology?
Absolutely, yeah. It's best for the players.
That's very dominant, isn't it, at the moment from the Chinese pet. And they've got their work cut out here, haven't they? Kido and Zebadiah, Bernadeth, if they're going to stick around.
Great shot from Markis. Built that up really nicely.
2-6.
Sean having to act as, I was going to say ball boy, but shuttle girl in this case.
Yeah.
Kind of mistakes, can they, at this stage?
Certainly not at the moment. No, they're just really struggling to string a series of points together. Every time they win one or two, they make an easy mistake to the back of them. Had some success with that return of serve, though.
Oh, it's her hair now, it's her laces. Fair to say she's not that comfortable on court at the moment. Here's Badia.
Either that or she's a great tactician.
Yeah, you've seen it before, haven't you? There are various tactics, aren't there, to slow the game down, you know, take the rhythm away from the opponents, yeah?
Absolutely, yeah, especially it was a wee while ago now, but when the rally point scoring system comes in, momentum can be, well, it is such an important part of the game, and if it's going in your favour, you just want to keep going and keep things in your speed, but if it's not, you need to be able to break that momentum somehow to keep yourself back in the match. There's a perfect example.
Get ready to play, please.
And he changed his serve to a flick serve. It didn't work.
It was well read.
It was. So, good little period there for Kido and Bernadeth.
Ah! not only did he win the point, the decibels have gone up a notch or two. He's not quiet, is he, Kido?
No, he's certainly having to work hard to win his points this afternoon as well, so he's really putting 100% into it. I think that's better, though, from him. He's just keeping the attack straight, and maybe it's on the guy. In theory, the girl has the weaker defense, but if he keeps that straight, he's not out of position, and therefore he can stay in there and get the easy kill. Straight to her racket. Well set up by the Chinese. Another uncharacteristic easy mistake from Kido.
Excellent rally. Well, that's the way to bring up the interval lead. What an excellent run here. What a fabulous way to finish it as well from Wu Xiaoyu. Yeah. 11 points to 7, a game up already. Chinese pair at the moment very much in control.
Yeah, they're certainly a lot more dangerous than the Indonesians at the moment. Kido's putting in everything he's got from the back line, but he just can't seem to put the shuttle on the floor.
I mean, from my untrained eye, it just seems to me that from the Indonesian pair, it just seems too one-dimensional, whereas there's more danger in various forms from the Chinese too.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, Kido possesses one of the best deceptive drop shots in the world. I mean, you've seen him play, you've seen it a few times, and I haven't seen that much this afternoon yet, but maybe that's something you can come with
20 seconds.
And cause a bit more trouble, but everything's going hard seconds. And it's all a bit too easy for the Chinese defensively, especially with someone like Huan, who's been around so long and is so good. She will turn it over straight away if your attack's not, you haven't made the right decision.
Because in that last rally, Kido was trying to focus on her with his attack, but she stood firm, didn't she, Sha?
Absolutely, yeah. Like I said, it has been a bit easier to defend in here this week. It's a little bit slower. So if you hit hard when you're off balance and out of position, you're going to get punished for it.
Why is it slower?
It's a good question. Yeah. And the bigger, this isn't one of, you see bigger halls than this around the world, but it's not small. But the can to do with temperature or just shuttle speed in general, often types of shuttles, some fluff up more than others after a good slice.
And particularly when you're in Asia, it's normally very, very hot, obviously, outside, so the air conditioner is ramped up. It's not that way, obviously, in Auckland in the autumn at the moment. So no need to crank up the air conditioning, is there?
No, not at all. But to be honest, it's been perfect conditions to play in. It's been a little bit slow. There's no drift, no wind in the hall at all. And as a result, we've seen some pretty good badminton.
Good.
Terrific defense from the Chinese. So hard to cover when you have to go from one side of the court and the extremes to the other.
That's a nice 5-point lead now, isn't it? A little bit of a hesitancy there. Easily gobbled up by Wu.
It's all been pretty straightforward for the Chinese this afternoon.
Well, they've won 6 of the last 7 points, and it's looking a big task now ahead for the Indonesians. That was left and well left.
service
by Kido, just long.
9-14.
They could do with a few cheap points, couldn't they?
Yeah, they could do with a few points. Doesn't matter how they come, he'll take them.
Well, that was a tired looking
service
shot from Kido.
15-9.
Wonder whether mentally, I'm not saying he would do it on purpose, but mentally with a men's doubles match to come later, the facing defeat in the face where the, you know, subconsciously might ease up a little bit.
Yeah, to be honest, he's probably not thinking about that one too much, but he's been playing two events. Yeah, exactly. He's been playing two events all week, and it's not easy at this level when he's made two semi-finals. He's played a lot of matches and he's spent a lot of time on court, so maybe it is a bit of mental fatigue.
It doesn't help when your sister does that as well. Yeah, they look a beaten pair right now, don't they? Kido and Zebadiah.
Yeah, it's just been a quality display from the Chinese. They just haven't let Markis and Pierre be able to win any points. They've had to work so hard for everything. I say that and they get a cheap
service
one.
Service over 10-17.
But it can be a little bit demoralizing when you have to work so hard to put the shuttle on the floor. And then, as you know, as soon as it goes up on the other side, they're going to come with a lot more weapons than you have.
Are you surprised, the scratch pairing like this? That, I mean, I know Shah's got a lot of experience, she's put that one
11,
why, but
17.
You know, we haven't really seen much of Wu Xiaoyu on an international stage before, put together for this week. Surprised to see them get all the way to the final?
12,
yes
17.
And no. Certainly, like I said before, the girl is a key to a good mixed doubles, and Shah's certainly shown her class this afternoon. She's really taken the net from Bernadeth and hasn't given her a chance to come in and get lifts. It's been the Chinese attacking all the time, and that's why they're, well, now 4 points up.
13-17.
And a setup.
Well, I never say never, but it would be a real turn up if the Indonesian pair could turn it around from here.
Yeah. Wouldn't write off an Olympic gold medalist, though.
Sure, that's 4 points in a row. If they can double that to 8 points in a row, then we've got a game. The umpire just saying to Xia Huan to get on. There's no sweat on the court. She's trying to rub it off. Again, another delaying tactic. Yes, sir.
Possibly, yeah. Like I said, the Indonesians won now. They won 4 points in a row. Slow it down a little bit.
Job's done.
And, yeah, paid off.
Edging closer, 2 points away now
13.
From victory. Well, 7 match points.
13.
And that brief resistance pretty quickly broken. He took just over half an hour, and you can see what it means to Wu Xiaoyu, celebrating his first final alongside Xia Huan. It was a pretty comprehensive victory as well, 21-15, 21-13, and surprisingly, I have to say, Oliver, very one-sided.
Indeed, yeah, I would have expected more going into it from the Indonesians to put up more of a fight than that, but they were just outclassed by a young scratch pair that was just better in pretty much all facets.
So the Chinese bet into the final, 21-15, 21-13. So Markis Kido has to shrug that off and get ready for the men's doubles. And for Shah, well, she's in action later as well in the women's doubles. Of course, the winner of that match we just saw will play Ricky Widianto, Richie Puspitadilly, or Zheng Siwei and Chen Qing Chen. Now, the number one seeds, of course, are the Indonesians that are on court at the moment on the other match, and it's the Chinese pair have taken a first set tighter match, though. So it could all be an all-Chinese final, the way things are going.
Yeah, certainly couldn't. I think that's been happening a lot. Recently we saw it in China Masters a few weeks ago. There were four out of the five finals were all Chinese. It was their home tournament, but they've got a young group coming through that's of a really high level.
Yeah, because you think that Chinese pair that we just watched, the ones on the other court, they're both teenagers. They really are.
Yeah, certainly the future looks pretty bright for badminton in China at the moment.
Yeah, Zheng Siwei and Chen Qingchen have won twice in just five tournaments, so they've got some pedigree. So if they did get through, you'd probably make them slight favourites, but you never know when it's an all-Chinese affair, if that's what it
is. Yeah, exactly.
Needs to be. Okay, well, let's hear from the winning pair, Stephen, alongside the Chinese winning pair of Xia Huan and Wu Xiaoyu.
Congratulations. You've just beaten the third seed. You look very excited about that.
Yes,
they are very happy, and they thought about they will win before the game, but they didn't know it will be so quick. And then, but they also learned a lot from the game.
Are you surprised how easy it was to get past the third seeds?
你有没有就是非常惊讶，就是如此容易，就是轻松就赢得了比赛？
对，so 很惊讶。
I'm just very surprised that's that easy.
Now, what was that word you used when you came in? You heard what did you say?
Unbelievable. Yeah.
See you in the final tomorrow.
Okay, thank you.
He's learning well. Yeah, they've knocked out the number three seeds, they've locked out the number two seeds. The number one seeds at the moment could well be going out of court, so it's wide open, isn't it, in the mixed doubles now?
It certainly is. Yeah, it's been hotly competitive all week, and you see guys that come from unseeded and go straight to the final. It's impressive, very impressive.
So obviously that's the first of our semi-finals. Then it's the women's singles that will be up next. That's really going to be a mouthwatering proposition with two teenage girls. Really, can't really call it a women's singles semi-final given their age. But this is what we've just been watching, the mixed doubles. And unbelievable, describe it any way you like. As they're saying, just weren't expecting it, were they, Wu and Xia, to be as comfortable as it was?
Absolutely not. Fair to say, I don't think Markis, Kido and Zebadiah put in their best performance today, but I also don't think they were allowed to. The Chinese played very, very well from the start and just didn't allow them to really get into the match, and we just saw a consistent run of uncharacteristic errors from the Indonesians.
Yeah, it was, I wouldn't quite call it mistake-free, but there were very few unforced errors, whereas you saw the face there appear, that was kind of the look that they got a lot. That's the winning moment. Yep. You certainly enjoyed that, and you've got to enjoy your wins, haven't you?
Certainly do. That's the nature of the sport. Like, you can make the final this week and then maybe you crash out first round next week, so you're going to enjoy your good times.
So the women's singles coming up next, but Chinese victory in the mixed doubles in our first. Be an all-Chinese affair because an easier duo, the number one seeds, Wulianta and Dili have turned the second game around, although it's still pretty tight all to play for.
Yeah, turned around the deficit into a one-point lead at 15-14 in the second.
I'm really looking forward to this women's singles match coming out. Can't quite call it a girls singles, but they have met each other very much as girls in the Junior World Championships. So there's a bit of history between Herbing Zhao and Aya Ohori.
Certainly is. Aya Ohori has had some really tough matches this week. She's played at least one marathon. It's been quite tired, so we're looking for maybe Herbing Zhao to play a bigger court. She's a left-hander with a lot of skill. and some really, really nice shots. So Aya Hoi is going to have to work really hard to overcome her this afternoon. But again, she's the 8th seed from Japan. She's got some experience and she's been around a little bit, so they know each other.
They're both 18 years of age. I mean, it's incredible they have got that much experience.
Yeah.
I watched her Bing Zhao play a couple of weeks ago in China. She was absolutely outstanding. I mean, she looked a different level to everyone else she was playing.
Yeah, absolutely. She's got her shots quality is something else. Really is.
Yeah, I've got that.
16, 15.
City has in common is when you walk outside, the show never stops. Auckland, the show never stops.
Yeah, we're just north of downtown Auckland in the North Shore Event Centre, and already one result done and dusted in the semi-finals of this New Zealand Open. And as you can see in the mixed doubles, victory for U and Sha, and pretty comfortably as well. Women's singles up next, then the old boy, if you like, Brun Sanktonsonner, although Lee Hugh Neal's playing on the other court in the men's singles, he's even older. Women's doubles, and then we finish it off with Malaysia up against Indonesia in the men's doubles.
Ladies and gentlemen, our second match on
still a mixed doubles match going on court two. It's a far tighter affair than the one we saw. But here come the girls, and I mean the girls, two 18-year-olds, two big talents who have made their mark at junior level and already, despite their age, Oliver, at senior level as well.
Yeah, it's scary how much they've achieved. They're both only 18 years of age. Now you're in a semi-final of a Grand Prix Gold, and one of them's going to be in the final. So it's, yeah, the bright, bright futures ahead.
What are you, 25?
Yeah, 25.
Well, I'm 20 years older than you, but do you feel old watching these girls play?
What about? I think about what I was trying to do when I was 18 and practicing. Yeah, wow, it's not even close to what they're capable of.
Well, it's I think a case here of Herbing Zhao being the favourite, but you just never know. Aya Hori has had some success against her before. So despite, I think yesterday after a match, she was saying things like, you know, I'll just try my best, try to win, trying to play it down, I think. And why not take the pressure off, make the other girl the favourite?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, she's coming in as a media ploy, that's how she believes. We'll see, but she's got to work. She's going to have a tough match. That's for sure. Both players will.
Well, that's Aya Ahura. World rank number 55. Her highest ranking, actually. She's the number 8 seed here. Well, Well, as you can see, that's her opponent, her being Xia. You're looking at the stats up, but Aya, well, it's all about 2020. She wants to be at the Olympics in Tokyo. Her dream is to win Olympic gold, and she's got some stiff competition, hasn't she, with Akane Yamaguchi and Nozomi Okahura, just a couple of her compatriots who are also teenagers who are pretty good, but they've got some really good young talent, haven't they, Japan?
Certainly do, yeah, especially also the women's doubles have been.
Coming into this match as the eighth seed, do you feel any pressure going into the semi-final?
Now I feel very exciting to play semi-final later.
You said after your quarterfinal that you were quite tired, that it had been quite a tough match, that you